Cancer survivorship is actually a fairly new field because, appropriately so, we've focused much of our energy as oncology providers and scientists and researchers on getting more survivors, getting people to a place where they're actually more likely to live through and beyond cancer for as long as possible. And so only in the last decade or so have significant focus and resources gone towards now how do we care for this growing number of people who are living through and beyond cancer, which is very exciting. In fact, in some ways, we're kind of victims of our success in that the patients are doing better on average, and thus we have created some new problems. Patients with long-term late effects, because they're getting there, and now we have to figure out how to better care for them and how to monitor better so that they don't have a new problem in the future, including a new cancer diagnosis, among other things. Medically speaking, survivorship is a lot about monitoring for long-term and late effects of both having had a cancer and then the associated treatment risks. It's also about monitoring for recurrence of cancer, because unfortunately many cancers, despite treatments getting better and better, have a risk of the cancer still coming back. And then patients who have had one cancer are often predisposed to secondary cancers or new primaries, so cancers that are either related to the treatment itself or related to the fact that the person has a body that was able to develop one cancer either because of a genetic predisposition and or exposure to the same exact things that were associated with developing the cancer to begin with. A cancer diagnosis and when a patient enters into the survivorship period in particular, that's a time when we can help a patient take stock of where they are in terms of their health behaviors and what can be changed. So for example, a lung cancer patient who's smoking, ideally you want to help them to quit smoking because a patient who survives one lung cancer is at a much higher risk of getting a new lung cancer if they're still a smoker. And of course, there are several other reasons to quit smoking. And there are numerous examples of that where patients who are overweight at diagnosis of a cancer and aren't exercising, we can try to help them to improve their health behaviors so that the rest of their life is better, both from a physiologic medical standpoint and risk standpoint, but also from a quality of life standpoint. Personally, I'm driven by caring for more and more cancer survivors in my clinic, seeing how difficult it can be for them, both physically if they're having side effects and long-term risks, as well as emotionally as they try and kind of muddle through and find a new normal for themselves, both again physically and emotionally. And so when I see that day to day, creating resources, creating that roadmap for them that can help to kind of at least allay some of the anxiety about you have a plan, stick to the plan, and hopefully you'll be okay, I think it can go a long way to help people feel better in the moment and along the way.